Hello, Royalty. Good morning and welcome to our touch point today. My name is Godgift Austin, the regular host and anchor to this channel. Like we used to do, to pick our topics, we deliberate on them scripturally to find out the mind of God in those areas of concern. In so doing, those questions have lingered over the years in our hearts and sometimes seem to have provided answers at the time. I have no doubt that your questions have been tackled in this platform. All you need to do is just to join us in our day-to-day fellowship. Subscribe and follow us when necessary. And make sure to go through the clips that are already uploaded here, over 300 of them. Before you finish, you'll discover how much the Lord has done for you. God bless you. Remember to share your testimony. Right, as the Lord is blessing you, shall we pray? My Father, my God, I thank you for what you are doing. Thank you because you are still changing lives. May your honor be ascribed to you this morning. We ask the Lord that you teach us once again. Glorify Jesus in our lives. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. So, we have been talking about affirmation. And I said, the question that was asked by that, whether it is bad to want affirmation. Is wanting affirmation ever unhealthy? And we are still in that question. And I want us to read the following passages, Matthew chapter 5 verse 16, Luke chapter 2 verse 52, Titus chapter 2 verse 6 to 8, 1 Thessalonians chapter 5 verse 11, Galatians 1 verse 10, John chapter 12 verse 43, 1 Timothy 4 verse 6 verse 5. And also I want you to read 1 Thessalonians 2 verse 4. For the summary of all these things we just mentioned is that winning human approval is not a bad thing. And in many cases, can be a good thing. Living a good, honorable life is an important part of our Christian witness. However, if we care more about success and human affirmation than faithfulness to God and His gospel, we have made a grave mistake. Sometimes, godliness leads to human affirmation. Sometimes it doesn't. So that is why it is important to cultivate a longing for God's affirmation above anyone else. Alright, so I want us to also read Proverbs 29 verse 5, 2 Timothy 4 verse 3 to 4, Psalms 12 verse 3, Proverbs 28 verse 3, Proverbs 27 verse 6. Just take time to read them, but then the summary I want to bring up from those passages is that flattery is false affirmation. Our hunger for affirmation may lead to people telling us what we want to hear that is true and manipulating us through that. A friend who speaks the truth even when it is difficult will be greatly what treasured. Alright, so these are the things I want us to look at. Take time to deliberate, brood over them. And the next time we want to meet, we will take it off from that place. I want us to commit it to God at this time. Like we read it last, I said, a friend who speaks the truth, even when it is difficult, should be greatly treasured. A lot of us engage in flattery. I don't know if you are such a person. Your life flattering people just to get affirmation from them. And you want to say, Lord, I want to start a new life with you this morning. I'm tired of that kind of life. I will pray together and say, just say after me, Lord Jesus, thank you for this opportunity. Thank you for today. Thank you for choosing this message for me to bless my life. Please forgive me my sins. Help me, O Lord. Wash me by your blood. Cleanse me of every unrighteousness. Write my name in the book of life deleted from the book of death. Give me a fresh start and a new beginning. Satan, I command you, withdraw your feeding hands from my life. You did not make me, you cannot keep me. My life is hidden with Christ in God, and to him I return. Thank you, Jesus, I am born again. In Jesus' mighty name we have prayed. Amen. Beloved, if you have prayed this prayer with me, I want to say a big congratulations and also encourage you to keep feasting in this world of life that sets men free. And I know you will never get it wrong. The Lord has equipped or prepared them to equip you. And to my listeners all over the world, I pray for you. This is weekend. This weekend, the Lord will identify with you and relocate you, reposition you to where you ought to be in the name of Jesus Christ. The Bible says, this is the day the Lord has made. We will rejoice and be glad in it. You will explore today sufficiently. And at the end of today, you will have reasons to give glory to God Almighty. He shall be well with you. Have a fruitful, fulfilled day. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. God bless you.